Like, I'd rather my kids start a fucking OnlyFans than show up like this. At this current point in time, there's only one thing sweeping the world faster than coronavirus, and it's TikTok. And I myself am a bit of a TikTok expert with my 6 following, 1 follower, and 0 uploaded TikToks. Which is why I've taken it upon myself to find you the cringiest TikToks I possibly could. And I'm gonna be real, it's not actually that hard to find just absolute cringe on TikTok. So without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, I present to you TikTok Cringe of the Year Edition. Oh my god, I hate myself already. This is my worst idea ever.
Daddy.
Like, what the fuck am I looking at? What is this? Like, just let me paint a picture. You've paid for 13 years of your child's schooling, and then they show up on TikTok cosplaying like an inbred elf or something. Like, I'd rather my kids start a fucking OnlyFans than show up like this. Hold up, oh my god, she's got an OnlyFans link in her TikTok profile. Oh, this is perfect. There you go, if you want to pay Josie Green, who's 25 years old from Austin, Texas, if you want to pay her $16.99 a month to see her naked, there you go ahead, do it. Oh wait, sorry, she goes by Malice on OnlyFans, so if you want to pay Malice $17 a month to see her naked, go ahead.
Look, Takashi! My cavity's all better now!
You sure?
The swelling has even gone down!
Has it?
You know when you were a kid and you had all those classic books, you had Goosebumps, Where's Wally? Who remembers Animorphs? Like, this, she looks like one of the characters who's meant to be on the fucking cover of Animorphs. And at the moment, you're probably thinking to yourself, oh, the video must be the cringiest bit about this TikTok. But you'd be incorrect because the comments are just as bad.
Oh, Senpai, you're so amazing, super amazing, cute, adorable, beautiful.
Yes, you can have a piece of cake. Cake emoji, halo emoji, hearts around face emoji, smiley emoji, wink emoji.
OMG, you're so cute. Must protect.
Alright boys, keep protecting your virginity. Make sure you never lose it. All I'm saying is, if you're allowed to procreate, I refuse to live in a world where furries outweigh the number of normal people. What the fuck? What did they use to film this? This is actually one of life's great mysteries because not even a Nokia flip phone would put out quality that bad. Like, to film that, she must have used, like, the phone that CJ uses in GTA San Andreas to start missions.
Hello.
I'ma put him in a dungeon under. None of bitches ain't eating, they ain't no hunger. Motherfucker, I need. Who the fuck is this whore?
Oh shit. Here we go again.
Somehow, she's converted that into a contraption that is capable of taking a TikTok. The lengths people will go to use this app is insane. But back to the actual TikTok. Why does it sound like she's, like, dying of hypothermia? Imagine the end of Titanic, Leonardo DiCaprio. He's about to freeze to death in the water and you just hear this. Alright, so this next one, it's not exactly, like, repulsive cringe like the first couple of TikToks in this video have been. It's more like, if you filmed this, you would get bullied at school type of cringe. Also, I have to edit music over this one so I can actually upload this video, so enjoy.
Oh! Awesome!
Here's a newsflash, champion. Everybody knows that it's wrong to cheat on your significant other. But even if I had a said significant other and cheated on her, I'd like to see you fly over to Australia to come and treat her right. But no, this man is speaking a good message. That's what you may be thinking. But then, if you look at one of his latest, you'll see this.
You're a bad thing. I know I fucked up,
doesn't seem very don't cheat on your girlfriend or I'll treat her right of you, Daniel. This man is literally capitalizing on everything he's got though. Like his TikTok is at light skin Daniel. You know, I might just rename this channel 6'6", brown eyes, brown hair, white Brayden. I mean, it just rolls off the tongue, doesn't it? I really hope I can keep the music in on this next one because without it, the TikTok just doesn't make sense at all. I know Joaquin Phoenix won a Academy Award for playing the Joker, but I mean, come on, they could have done so much better with Paperface here. I mean, seriously, how many other people have you seen who can pull off both the Joker scar makeup and grayscale from Game of Thrones? It's literally the biggest crossover since Avengers Infinity War. Next up, we've got one that really hits home for me. Alright Shay, just because I have the body composition of Mantis from Kung Fu Panda doesn't mean my legs are gonna fucking snap if you sit on them.
I wasn't born with osteoporosis, motherfucker.
Yeah, look, also, at least I know what size pants I wear. I mean, look, you've rolled them up about 8 times so they fit you. At least I can go down to Kmart, go, oh, praying mantis size 6, and I know that's what I wear. Shout out to all my hashtag mantis boys out there, love you all. I didn't actually know about this, but TikTok actually has a pretty committed Christian community. And when I say Christian, I mean Christian.
Okay, my life is not perfect, but my God is. And I promise whatever struggle you're going through, God's going to be with you and he's going to take care of you as long as you follow him. Go drink some coffee, enjoy the sun, eat some pancakes.
If I wiped my dog's bum with pancakes, that's kind of what I imagine they'd look like after.
Go kayaking.
Yes, go kayaking in the garden, which has gravel roads. And I'm not an ecological or a geological expert, but I'm willing to bet that the water composition of gravel is probably close to zero. And you may think it ends there, but it most definitely doesn't. Christianity will never die on TikTok.
Only think about them on the weekdays and weekends, only in the mornings and evening, only when I wake up and sleep.
So, by thinking only about Jesus every moment of the day, would you say you are lusting for Jesus? Because I'm no biblical expert, I may have gone to a Catholic school all my life, but lust, isn't lust the first of the 7 deadly sins? So, if you've got so much lust for Jesus, does that make you a hardcore sinner? I don't know how many of you have seen that video of the Christian Char Char slide, but these Christian TikToks just remind me so much of that. It's fucking funny. I'll play some clips for you if you haven't seen it.
Hey y'all, this right here is the Bible slide, featuring the Freedom Band. Alright, we about to have some spiritual milk. To the left. Take a step of faith. Pray once this time. On the devil, let's stomp. On temptation, let's stomp. Bible slide real smooth. Now praise and shout.
I was actually going to end the video there, but I've just stumbled upon another Christian TikToker. And he could be more fanatical than the last one. Oh, this couldn't get more perfect. And relating to the intro to this video, he's got TikToks that incorporate both Christianity and the coronavirus. I don't know about that one, sport. I could probably think of a couple more things than 3, maybe like hand sanitizer, face masks, showering properly, not coughing on people, quarantine, a vaccination when they release them. So there you go, I just named 6 more things that didn't have to do with religion. Alright, so before the drop of the song, have a quick think to yourself. What do you think he's going to say they have in common? If I had to take a guess, it's gonna have something to do with dying and going to heaven or something like that. I don't really know what that means, but I almost had an aneurysm trying to read it as it popped up. But this will be the last TikTok for the video, so enjoy.
Jesus Christ loves you.
So there you go. If you take one thing away from this video, take away the fact that Jesus loves you. Fuck, that's funny. Not what he actually said in the video, but the little gremlin run up to the camera, that was pretty hilarious. You know, actually, I respect this man's hustle. It's pretty like, what he's doing, it's different, I suppose. And he's got Blaziken as his TikTok picture, so that's pretty sick. Gen 3 earns you clout. But hey, I actually had a fair amount of fun making this video, as much as I wanted to die from the cringe. But if you enjoyed it, please subscribe, drop a like, comment, it all helps me very much. But my name's Brayden, you've been watching Banda Boulevard, and I really hope I see you in the next video. Tastes so dark, you cannot see who I'm riding with. Diamond glisten all up in my watch, can't tell what time it is. Diamond clusters all up in my watch, they got you blind as shit. I tied a beat up, then I fuck it, yeah, I'm on some violent shit. Woo! Don't wanna tell you again.